It's easy to think that after you've written all of your model functions that you've got your model. But in fact, this is the stage at which you really need to think whether or not all of the things that you are hoping to accomplish with your model in implementing your hypotheses has actually happened. This is the step that we call model completion. What we've learned is that with the draft model and workflow, it should have been relatively straightforward to implement all of the model details. Of course, that doesn't mean you didn't have to think a bit. Hopefully that you're always thinking. But now that you've implemented the overall model structure, it's time to check if we're actually done. Model completion means that we do sanity checks overall. You need to ask a series of questions. Does the model address the original question sufficiently? And in this case, that's easy. You need to check, does your model produce illusions? Does it speak to the hypotheses? Translated, that means you should be able to see the impact that the vestibular noise is making on the simulations in a way that it should be generating these illusory percepts. Finally, does the model qualitatively make sense? Do all of the relationships, once you instantiated them and you output them, do they produce the things that you think that they should? Very often, if we vary the range of our inputs to reasonable values, we should always, in our code, get back reasonable values. And if we vary our functions outside of reasonable values, hopefully there will be something graceful that our model or simulations do. If you don't check these things, it can be very difficult if you have an optimization step in your model to make sure that something doesn't break along the way. So during the model completion stage, it's all about the sanity checks. Here we'll go through and do our sanity checks for our model, making sure that everything makes sense.